Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the BGP local preference attribute. Now, before I get started, just a short reminder, if you like what you see in my videos, please click that subscribe button so you can be updated for newly uploaded content. So what is the local preference attribute? It's a BGP attribute that's used to determine the exit path out of an autonomous system. According to the official RFC, it's the very first attribute that's examined in the BGP best path algorithm. If we take into account the Cisco proprietary attribute of weight, then local preference is the second attribute to be examined. If you want to find out more about the weight attribute, take a look at the relevant video link in the description below. So let's take a look at some of the characteristics of local preference. First of all, local preference is a 32-bit value ranging from 0 to over 4 billion, and it has a default value of 100. The attribute is often written out like this, and it's often called local preference or local pref interchangeably. It's an attribute that's shared between IBGP peers, but not between EBGP peers. This means that it always is contained within an autonomous system. It's never advertised externally. It is a well-known discretionary BGP attribute, which means that every BGP router must recognize and correctly implement this attribute. And finally, it is the path with the highest local preference that is always preferred. So what does all this mean practically when we look at a BGP topology? Well, let's take a look at this particular topology. Here we have three BGP routers within AS100. Routers R2 and R3 receive information about the 30.30.30.0/24 network. Let's go through what would happen if we kept all BGP parameters at their defaults. Let's first take a look at the BGP table of R1. You can see here that both paths via R2 and R3 have already been installed in the BGP table. However, one has been chosen over the other. Why is that? Let's go through the algorithm process to find out. First, we take a look at the weight of each path. The weight is equal, so we go on to the next attribute. Next, we look at the local preference. We see here that this value is equal as well. Both routes are set to a value of 100. So we go on to the next attribute. Then we look at the originate attribute. Now this attribute essentially says that we prefer prefixes that were originated by the local router. But in this case, neither prefix was originated by the local router. Both were learned from BGP peers. So this attribute does not play a role. The next attribute is the AS path. Here we see that one AS path is longer than the other, thus we have our tiebreaker. So in this scenario, the green path via R2 will be preferred. So the path that was chosen as the best path, as indicated by the greater than sign here, is via a next hop of 2.2.2.2, which is the R2 router. And this is because of the fact that the AS path via R2 is shorter. I'd just like to emphasize again here, notice the local preference value for both of these paths is set to that default of 100. Now this is what we will attempt to change in order to modify the choice of the best path. So let's go in and change that local preference attribute to cause R1 to prefer to exit the autonomous system via R3 rather than via R2. And we can do this by adjusting the local pref value of the BGP configuration of R3. Let's go into that configuration of router R3 and make that change. Here we enter the configuration of the BGP AS100 and we use the BGP default local preference 200 command. This command essentially says that any BGP route that is shared with any IBGP peer will have a local pref value set to 200. This is a global configuration parameter, and it's applied to all prefixes that are advertised to IBGP peers. Now let's see what effect this has on R1's BGP routing decisions. Here we can see that the best path is now the path with the next hop of 3.3.3.3, which is via R3. Now we can also see the configured local pref value for that particular prefix, which is now set to 200, which is indeed the value that was advertised by R3. So now all prefixes advertised by R3 into our AS of 100 will have a local pref of 200. So for any and all prefixes learned by both R2 and R3, the outbound path out of the local AS will be via R3. Now one may ask, what if I want to use R3 as the outbound path for some prefixes and R2 for others? It is possible to change the local pref on a per prefix basis. I won't show it here, but it can be done using route maps and having those route maps applied to IBGP peerings. That way you can tweak the local pref of specific prefixes only, giving you much more control over how to route outbound traffic out of your AS. So from this example, you can see that the local preference is essentially used in BGP to influence the outbound traffic routing decisions in an autonomous system. Higher values of local preference are preferred over lower values, allowing network administrators to control the path selection process for exiting traffic. This is especially useful because you have a very high level of control when it comes to routing traffic to neighboring ASs. You may want to choose one exit point over another due to cost, traffic level agreements with your neighboring ASs, or simply because you have more bandwidth available via one path compared to another. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.